So this is me, Ashutosh, once again, and welcome to my channel OpenEmails.in, which is my take on computer vision. So this is a little bit about me. I am Ashutosh Upadhyay. I am a computer vision and deep learning engineer and a freelance programmer. I enjoy playing around with images, which you will see today. We are going to learn that as well. I have started my college newspaper Sankalp during my college days, which my college was in July. So to follow OpenEmails, this is very important because I have just created these pages and you may try to find out the contents over there and give your comments and feedback. So on Facebook, you can go to search tab and you can type @OpenEmails.in and you will find my page. On YouTube, you can go to OpenEmails and not .in, right? Because there is some there is some problem with Google that they have to verify that if OpenEmails.in is a company or not. They don't let you register. So it's simply OpenEmails over there. You can find out by looking at the profile pic, which is me, and this is a face detection and eye detection. Third is the website. This is http://openimage.in, openimage.in, right? It's live now, but I have just purchased the domain name, so you will not find contents over there, but probably by the next weekend, I would say, I will try to put content over there. But yes, there is no issue. You can find the same content, similar content on YouTube and Facebook page as well. So till that, you can browse those pages. Okay. So let's come to today's agenda. What we are going to do is video, we figured out how to read an image using OpenCV. Now, so there were questions that came to my inbox and they were saying that this course went very fast. We didn't understand how to read an image. We didn't understand the framework. And you just show us how to read the image. So, okay. That was the first image. That was the first video. So I thought I would give a broad overview of what you are going to see. And I have seen people, they are interested in first looking at the output. And then they get motivated. So that was my intention at that time. But okay. So now we will understand how an image is represented in OpenCV. So see, when you take an image using your camera or whatever image you have in your laptop, see, they get, so the object out there is a 3D image. It is a 3D object. And that 3D object gets converted to a 2D object on your camera frame. Now, your image consists of pixels. The smallest value of any image is called as pixels. Now, in OpenCV, this is represented by height, width, and color channel. It's an array. If you have a little bit computer science idea, you have gone through C, or you have worked on mathematics M1 probably in your engineering classes. You understand what is matrix. So all the images are represented as a matrix in OpenCV. Now the first value is height, followed by width, and then there is color channels. Now we will come to color channels next. See, there are two type of images we will be talking right now. The first one is a grayscale image, where there is grayscale, or I would say it's a binary image, where there are only two values. These are white and black, and in between, from black slowly to white. Now, and the second one is your RGB value. RGB means red, green, and blue. So, when I speak about a color image, you should understand it like three different images coalesced together. So, one image is a red channel, second image is a green channel, and third image is a blue channel. Now we have all these three images and we just superimpose one over the other. So this is an RGB image. When you will do that, you will get a color image. So any image that you are taking through your camera, your mobile phone camera, or any camera, it's a digital image. That means that is an RGB image. On and in OpenCV, it is represented as VGR. VGR. So the first blue, then green, followed by red. We will see just in a moment. We will do it in code, so don't worry if you are not getting to the if you are not understanding exactly what red, green, blue and how we are going to see that, we will do it in code. Now another important thing is, now every channel, see, when I told you that the image can go from zero to black to little bit and then it moves on to white, it means that zero value is stark black, it's exactly black, and 255 is white. So now when I say 127, then you should understand that it might be just at the median, just at the middle of black and white, that is gray. So when I say 70 80, so you should understand it is not perfectly black, it's not perfectly white, it's somewhere near black. So it goes in that way. So here is an image. I googled it, and there is no credit to me. This credit goes to its author. Now this image, I would try to show you the concept which we were just looking at. Just look at the first corner here. You can see this is a white pixel, right? Now white pixel has a value of 255. So corresponding value will be 255. Now for every pixel, so see, the way the writer has made it, he has divided all the pixel by 255, right? Pixel divided by 255. So see, if this is white, this means that this is 255 by 255, that this has to be one. So you can see all those pixels up to here, you will find one. Now as soon as this one goes to little bit gray, this is 0.9, right? 0.9 means what? This is the pixel value divided by 255 into 0.9. this is the exact value. Similarly, you just move on to this pixel and you will see this is exactly zero. This is my whole idea is, this is the whole idea of grayscale image. So this is a grayscale image, and you can see the stark black is zero, exactly white color, complete white color is one, and as the intensity is getting increased from black to towards white, it is increasing from zero towards 255, or I would say is zero towards 1.0 here. Let's see one more example. Let's look at this. So this pixel, you should see one, it's 0.9, and see, and just beside it is 0.8, and you can see this is darker. So this is how the pixel values are calculated, right? Okay, so as I promised you, we will see that in code. So let's go to code, and I will go to my folder open image, and we will just open our Jupyter notebook like previously we have did. So by now you must have installed Jupyter notebook, I guess, and if not, please do install it to follow alongside me. So let's start. We have this Jupyter notebook. So we have this. I have prepared some notebooks for you for this session. Let's start by flipping image. I just tested all this, that's why you can see the output over here. Okay, so the first, we are importing the CV2 package and NumPy package, then we are going to read an image, and then we are going to flip that image along x-axis, y-axis and xy-axis. So this is let's do it. So let's import CV2 and NumPy. Now secondly, we will read an image and print its shape. So let's read an image. Wow, where is the image? I can't see it. Anybody can tell why this is happening? Let me tell you. Because we are not returning the IAM show from here. So we can write cv2.imshow, and then image, and then we will return this img, and we will just copy this here to show you. Let's show you this. Okay, let's run it. Wow, we have the image. What happened? This image is not fitting in, this is me, but this image is not fitting in the window. What to do now? How we are going to proceed? We will not be able to see it. Just kidding. Now see, this might happen. So when the image size is too large or too big, it will not fit in your window, or you might want to just resize the image from smaller to larger size. So for that, we have a function called resize in CV2. So let's do that. So we will just resize it. CV2.resize. We will take that the first our image, and then we will define the size of the window we are expecting. So let's say my screen is, let's say, 1920 cross, you know, whatever, 1200. So I will just, let's say, I will have 600 comma 480, let's say 480. Okay, and so this image is should be resized to this, and just return it to the same image variable. Control Z. This is image. Now control enter. So this will be in the client while scanning. Still an error. Yeah, image CV2.resize image. What happened? It will resize image from 600 already. And then, oh my goodness! So this is here. Yeah. So this is the resized image, right? So okay. So to play around, let's just make it 200. Let's see the output. Yes, it's resized, right? So we can resize the image to play around it, and as per our convenience or the requirement of the project. So let's see it. Yeah, so that's fine.